Number 1. Inactivity. Exercise and activity play a big part in getting belly fat off, so it makes sense that little to no exercise or activity is a big factor in putting it on. People who watch more than 3 hours of TV per day double their risk of abdominal obesity than people who watch just 1 hour. Number 2. Eat sufficient clean protein. Undereating protein and overeating carbs can lead to weight gain. Make sure your protein is anti-inflammatory, that is, lentils and other legumes, if you tolerate them, cold water, low mercury, wild-caught seafood like salmon, cod, and steelhead trout, and pastured and wild meats, if you eat them, like elk, bison, and grass-fed beef. Stress. Stress can cause belly fat. The body interprets any stress the same, whether it is physical stress such as smoking, or perceived stress such as driving in rush hour. The bottom line for stress in the body is the production of the hormone cortisol, and cortisol, unfortunately, encourages the body to deposit more fat at our bellies. Read here how stress affects your metabolism and how to beat it. Number 4. Skip belly bloating beverages. Avoid alcohol. The occasional social drink is fine, but a little goes a long way, says Shames. Large amounts of alcoholic beverages, especially in the evening, are proven to have a bloating effect. Other beverages that aren't helping your cause, coffee, it can irritate your GI tract, and soda. Many dieters believe that drinking zero-calorie soda won't have a negative impact on their physique, but the truth is that the carbonation in fizzy drinks, even sparkling water, can cause belly bloating when the gas from the carbonation settles in the stomach. Number 5. Genes. Genes can be a major factor in belly fat and obesity. You know, when people say, "Oh, it is in the genes, auntie so-and-so was fat, my mom was fat, my sister is, and so I am too," there is actually genes that are markers for obesity. A 2011 study states there are more than 40 known gene variants that are associated with obesity and fat distribution. Epigenetic markers did not mean that you have to be overweight, it just elevates your risk, and hopefully motivates you more to make better choices to avoid obesity.